thank you all so very much for coming. It really means a lot. First on the program for tonight, I'm doing Bach's Cello Suite Number 1. Obviously, this is not a cello, so it's a guitar arrangement. I'm playing a combination of the Duart arrangement and the Rain arrangement, which were both written around the 60s. But my lovely teacher, John Fitzgerald, edited these arrangements to make them a little better. There's a few basses and things that were added in at the time that just, because obviously the basses weren't in the original manuscript because cello can't play chords while doing melody. So to make use of the guitar, chords and basses were added in. But some of those chords and basses changed the original harmonic sort of function of passages. So John very kindly edited it for me to make it better. So yeah, I hope you enjoy.
Thank you. Thank you.
All right, now I'm going to take you well out of the realm of nice to listen to Bach. This next piece, next suite, is called Quatre Pièces Breves. It's written by a Swiss composer, Frank Martin. He wrote it in 1933, and he's a post-tonal composer. So it's got a very interesting kind of harmonic language. He actually wrote it for, or inspired by, the playings of Andrés Segovia, who some of you have probably heard of, a very famous classical guitarist. And he mailed it to Segovia, and Segovia never replied to it. So Martin, who didn't normally write for guitar, assumed that, oh, well, can't be that great then. So he never wrote for guitar again. So this was his first and final guitar work, which is a real shame, because it's actually a really good one for guitar. There's a little more to that story in the program that I put in. But yeah, anyway, I hope you enjoy, and if you don't, my recitals are tough.
Thank you.
This is the last piece on our program. It's a duet for harp and guitar by Máximo Diego Pujol, who's an Argentine composer who sort of grew up on tangos and milongas and traditional, you know, Argentine music. And he sort of, when he composes, he likes to fuse sort of conventional classical styles with the tangos that he grew up with. So there's a movement of this that is a tango, and there's a movement that's a candomba. And a candomba is a dance that's in the region, because he was born in Buenos Aires. Yeah, and it uses guitar and harp, which gives it this sort of cool, unique sound world. And that's about all it is. Thank you.
Thank you. Do you want another thing? Something, you want something else?
Yeah!
All right, it's something completely different. But as many of you would know, I haven't just done classical this year. I've been studying classical, but I've been playing all sorts of stuff. Not least funk. A lot of it. And my classical is degree and all the teaching from John has helped me no end in this regard. I've got so much better, I hope. I'll play some funk for you. Just while I'm madly running around setting all this up, a few important thank yous. Huge thank you to John, of course. He really does deserve it. My face. he's the most dedicated teacher I think I've ever come into contact with. He always goes above and beyond, puts in way more than he has. Way more than he has any right to. He deserves all the praise he gets and more. A huge thank you to all the staff at the con as well. Constant support, fantastic teaching. It's been really, really great. And the admin staff as well, without whom this would just collapse into a chaotic mess. It's three people and the university owes them everything. Huge thank you to all my fellow students as well for the wonderful environment that they've created, and all the support that's given me and the confidence that's given me. A huge thank you to Simon Rovers Herman, who I'm sure is here tonight, for starting me down this path and all his support, and for making my beautiful guitar. If you want a nice guitar, hit him up. Huge thank you to my parents and my little sister, who's sitting right there. The continued unwavering support and free taxi service. Thanks to these guys for agreeing to play with me, Doug Laurie, Isaiah Quintana. Big thank you to Rachel Fish, who is up there. Thank you. I look forward to playing it again at your recital. You should all go to Rachel's recital. It's on the 22nd? 23rd. Anyway, here's Beastly vocals.